Hi guys, welcome back to my channel, Cookie with Auntie Val, and today it is juicy meatloaf time, guys. I'm gonna make us a nice meatloaf for dinner tonight. I have my 3 pounds of ground turkey. I have my carrots, my celery, onions, and bell peppers there. Then I have my black pepper, my salt, my tomato sauce, my breadcrumbs, my seasoned salt and garlic powder, my 2 eggs, my flour, my oil, and some ketchup and some brown sugar, guys. Once I get everything cut up, I'll be back. Okay, guys, now that I have all my vegetables cut up, I didn't cut all of the carrots that I had on my tray. I just thought that would just be a little too much. So I cut up my onions, my bell peppers, my celery, and my carrots. Now, I am going to add them into my ground turkey. I don't cook with ground beef anymore. I use ground turkey. You know, trying to eat healthier. As you get older, you want to try to, you know, be a little more careful, mindful of what you eat. So, put the vegetables in like this. Okay, have all of those in there. Okay, now next, I'm going to add my, gonna add my seasoning salt and my garlic powder. I kind of already put it into a container. I'm just gonna shake it on a little bit, round and around like that. Okay, next, I'm going to bust my eggs. I'm gonna put my eggs in here. Okay, normally, I like to get a fork, whip my egg before I just pour it in. Just kind of whip it up. A little bit, break the yolk up. Okay, pour that all around in there. And then I take my sugar, my flour. And I sprinkle my flour in there. Now this is a half a cup of flour, so I'm not sure how much of this I'm gonna use. I just kind of play it by ear. So I'm gonna put that much in it. Then I'm gonna come over and I'm gonna put some of my breadcrumbs in it. And I kind of estimate about the same thing. Maybe I start off with like a half a cup and then I just put until, you know, see how things go. Then I'm gonna add my oil. I'm gonna add a little oil in it because when you're using ground turkey, it tends to get dry sometimes. So I just put just a little oil. This is only a tablespoon, okay? Next, I'm gonna get my gloves. Put my gloves on. I don't want meat through my nails. So I'm gonna slide my gloves on like so. Now it's time to get busy. Now I'm going to take the spoon out first. Then I'm going to mix everything up with my hand. I'm going to use my hand. I'm going to mix it all up together here. And then all dependent on the consistency of the meatloaf, then that's when I'll either add more of the flour or more of the breadcrumbs, and I still have to put in my tomato sauce. I'll put like a small whole can of tomato sauce in. Sometimes I use a half, but it all depends. So it depends on how much meat I'm working with. And this is 3 pounds, so therefore I don't want it to be dry at all, so I have to make sure that I put enough in. Okay, I think I'm going to add in a little more of the flour. I just put all of that in there, and then I'm going to add in some more breadcrumbs. And I like to get the breadcrumbs. These are Italian style breadcrumbs. Okay, it's the kind I like to use. Give it a little more flavor. A little more flavor without the salt. So sprinkle that around. Then I'm going to add in my tomato sauce. So I'm take this around. And start off with a half a can. Now I'm gonna get this mixed up. think I'm gonna put the rest of this can in. I think I'll put the rest of this in here. A whole can. A whole can in here. And remember, it's 3 pounds. All of this up, then I'm going to oil my pan down, and then I'm going to mold my meatloaf into my container. Okay, looks, feels good. Okay, I'm gonna get some oil. A mess here. Okay guys, this is a pot that I'm going to use to put my meatloaf in. I'm just going to put just enough in there to wet the bottom down. Just a little bit, not much. Okay, I'm going to come out this glove and I'll use my hand and just kind of go around the bottom. Okay, all over the bottom and a little of the sides. Okay guys, now it's time to pop this baby into my pot here. Top it up here. Okay, get out of the way. Okay, next we have meatloaf. Slide it right on out into your bowl, into your container. Black pepper on top. Kind of forgot to put it in it, so I'm doing it on top here. Okay. Next, I'm gonna pop it in the oven. My oven's already on 350. I'm gonna pop it in the oven for about 45 minutes or longer, maybe an hour, it all depends. I'm gonna check back after half an hour, okay guys? So when I get to that half an hour point, I'll be back. Okay guys, this is at the 45 minute time that my meatloaf's been in there. And I think it needs still a little more time to go. So I'm gonna let it stay and put it in for about another half an hour, but after another 15 minutes, I'm gonna take it out and then I'm gonna put my glaze on top and then I'll put it back in for another 15 minutes and it should be ready. Okay guys,
I'll be back.
Okay guys, it's been a whole hour and I believe it is ready. So I'm gonna take it out and put my glaze. Remember I told you I needed ketchup and my brown sugar and that can of tomato sauce is what I mixed all in together and I'm gonna put that on top and I'll be right back. Okay guys, pouring my glaze on top all over. going to set this back in the oven for another 15 minutes and it's done, y'all. Okay, guys. Looks like the meatloaf is done. It's ready. So I'm going to cut a couple slices and show you, okay? I'm going to serve it up. Okay, guys. And there you have it. That's how I make my meatloaf. Thanks for stopping by and hanging out with me. And I hope that when you make my meatloaf that your family will enjoy it as much as mine will. And please, don't forget to comment, like, and subscribe. Till next time. Bye.